he is leading the tournament together with Shahriyar Momidyarov. Okay, third round, he plays experienced Israeli grandmaster Boris Gelfand. He have chosen Trompovsky. Well, very, very popular opening.
For Bliss especially.
Yeah, for Bliss players, yes, that's true. That's true, the favorite of the great Bliss master from my city, from St. Petersburg, Genrikh Chepukaitis. And, well, I think that...
Okay. Now it's transposed a bit into Benoni when white doesn't play c4 and plays knight.
Yeah, some strange setup. Looks more or less like Benoni, but pawn is on c2. Well, it has its advantages, it has its drawbacks. Alexander does not know how to use it, so he spends time. Okay, so
how to develop? Actually, white has quite easy development. Knight f3, bishop to d3, probably castle should be the main ideas, right?
Yeah, that's true. But he has always to think about some b5 stuff. Okay, I think something like knight f3, castle, bishop d3, then it's already time to think about b5. There are always
such tricks
in this kind of position. Yeah, I think
bishop d3 is on the board, castle, yes. Knight f3, bishop g4, we don't have to worry.
Okay, bishop g4, it's
another move,
but still it's bishop pair. I think that's what white shouldn't be very much worried about, but I don't know what. Okay, so okay, maybe b5 just simply doesn't work.
Because bishop b5
knight e4, but b5 just simply knight b5. Yeah, and then there is no tactics. Well, so probably really time to switch to this plan with bishop g4, getting rid of these y squared bishops.
It's very usual in Benoni structures.
Well,
but e6 is also quite a topical move.
Yes.
De6, do they choose de6 quite often?
Well,
castle is more.
Yeah, de did not look like a most natural choice. I think now black has easy development. Black has all chances to organize d5. Okay, in general, Boris Gelfand, I think, might be happy with the result of the opening. Okay.
He has obvious moves and it will be easy for him.
Yes, and his play is easier. Okay, that's very important. He has
probably
extra minute.
He has also maybe aiming for d5, or e5 might come a bit unpleasant.
Well, I don't really believe so, because okay, this pawn on e5,
yeah,
it can
d5
be only weakness. Yes.
Right. E d5, and we have massive exchanges on d5, which I think it was in black's favor. Now he has free play, but also white is not in any danger, let's say, like this.
Yes, it's obvious that black has just comfortably equalized, but most probably not more, because okay, this pawn on c3, it closed the diagonal for the bishop, and well, what can he do now? He can, let's say, play queen f6, forcing this exchange on f3. I think this
rook d8 also. Queen b6 is another choice to keep an eye on b2.
Well,
queen f6 I liked more, actually.
Quite interesting. Okay, Alexander allows this weakening exchange on f3. Well, considering that his bishop pair will be more valuable factor in this structure, well, I don't know. I think that it's still about equal, although white bishop, let's say, when it will come to I think d5 is sort of dream square,
and f4 f5 might be also something that white might want to, but now knight f3 is the threat, so white has to do something for
yeah, bishop e4, and then
bishop
okay.
d5, as you mentioned, it's quite dream square for white bishop. Rook d8 is probably natural. Oh no, c4
preparing good square d3 for the knight. It's a very reasonable idea, I think.
Rook d1, also quite natural move. 2 minutes for each player.
Yeah, so Boris Gelfand had this 1 minute handicap not long ago, but well.
I think that
pawn sacrifice.
He did not want not
a pawn sacrifice actually, because bishop d3 is met with rook e1. Yes, very nice trick by Boris Gelfand. So I think that still he has everything under control. Okay.
Rook e2 now. Bishop d3, it's kind of a threat. Rook d8, probably it's logical move to.
Rook d8 is good one. Rook d8 is good one, because or maybe not, because okay, rook d8, bishop d3 then.
Yeah,
it,
and cd3, rook e8, rook e8, and
rook
d3.
Rook d3, and
it's
a pawn is a pawn. Yeah, queen a6.
Queen a6. Still, I can take, or then the a2 bishop, a2 pawn will be
under some
pressure, so black will have a chance.
Yes, and after a3, rook d8,
bishop d3,
very solidly defended.
Rook e8, and I think queen d3.
Yes, Alexander went for this. Oh, yeah, after queen a2, maybe queen b5 was what Boris Gelfand has underestimated.
Queen b5 attacking the rook on e8 and also keeping an eye on b7 and protecting the b2 pawn.
Yes, yes, yes.
Very, very nice move.
And this kingside weakness is not a problem for white with this material. Bishop on g3 protects everything solidly.
King g2 also will be there quite solidly protecting the f3 pawn. And also extra pawn on queen side will affect the game.
Yeah, so it looks like somehow Alexander Grishuk managed to outcalculate. Okay.
Queen d7, queen e6, and queen b7, I guess, with the same idea as you had.
Yes, a pawn is a pawn. Yes, a pawn is a pawn. I think. Well, Alexander probably thinking about, well, queen e6. But I think rook e6 is not a problem for black. After rook d8, bishop f8,
bishop d6. There is no bishop d6.
There is no bishop d6, and
d6.
No way to exploit this back rank weakness.
But still, queen
e6. Still, he goes for this. I think he has to.
Maybe
take
he
rook.
Did not like something queen e2 or something like this after queen b7. But we anyway already don't have the queens on the board, and rook d7, also emphasizing that the pawns are weak. Rook b6 was not a move, because then rook d8 would work.
Not so sure about it. Okay, rook
no.
d8, bishop f8.
I mean, instead of h5. So h5 had.
But okay, I thought, okay,
still.
Rook b6, yeah. And now.
Still, right, controlling the d6.
Now Boris is aiming for bishop's endgame. Well.
Yeah.
Nice
rook
trick.
Rook e8, it's a nice
trick.
Though king h7 is still possible if I don't want to.
Although I don't see big difference actually.
Right.
Yes, then moving this pawn to a4.
We have bishop at games, and black has 15 seconds, which is not too much.
Yes, but bad news for him that white king is just in time
to grab
to c4.
King
now
is very
b3.
Important piece, as we know, in the endgame, so.
Now b3, okay, more or less it looks like technical win for white, although maybe with some tricks. I think that's quite important, that black's only queenside pawn will be blocked on black square, okay, after this b3, but.
B3 was important.
But f2 is a weakness, okay, so. What to do now?
Very interesting. Now bishop e5 looks
yes.
nice. Bishop maybe to d4.
H3 just in
H3,
case.
H3, yeah.
No, he just.
He wants to change the pawns. A4 doesn't seem to be so good, I guess, because. Oh, We have a4 on board.
I think it's more or less the only chance. I think it's more or less the only chance for black, because otherwise it would be just too easy technical win. And now...
Now b5.
This pawn on a4...
It can be a bit of trouble for white sometimes, escape.
No. c4, c5, game over.
Right.
Yeah. Yes.
King c2, just in case, so there is